26th, 2015. Phony texting with Dad. Haven't made any videos this year. Been pretty lazy. Haven't been finding a whole lot, but found a place a couple days ago. 2 hours I dug up 8 wheat pennies and 5 silver dimes. I got 3 marks and 2 rosies in a local park that's been hunted out, supposedly. So Dad and I are gonna go down there today and hopefully I can get some live digs. It'd be nice if we got at least 10 silvers today. I'm wishing, as long as I don't hit a deer in this fog. I'm sure he's gonna be late too, because we meet every weekend. We live about 100 miles apart. So we meet in the middle, in Madison, every weekend. Spend the day together hunting. So hopefully today we get some silvers and I can do some live digs if we can get through the fog. I'll get back to you when we get on site. Bye. Well, out here with Dad today. There he is. Got the big coils on. First coin I dug today is wheat. Definitely wheat. I don't know what year it is. Maybe you can see it. Oh, looks like a 44. Cool. Well, it's down about 6 inches, so I'll get back. Next hole. Bye. Back again. Second coin of the day. I got 19. Can see that 1941 nickel, almost silver. Whoops, go back here. No mint mark. Oh, 1941 though. That's nice. Back to you on the next hole. Okay, I got a signal here. Could be silver. Stuff down there. It's a little jumbled, but let me open up the hole and see what it is. Okay, I got it out of the hole. Right there, whatever it is. Oh, looks like a penny. Definitely a wheat. I'll get a date on it. Focus. Can't see it. Looks like 50 something. 50, 58. Yep, 58. Well, it's not silver, but it's wheat. It's 2 for the day. Back in the next hole. Just had a real crappy signal. It's down about 5 inches. I don't know if it's a wheat or not, but we'll find out. Yep, it's a wheat. I'm gonna clean it off, see if we can get a date. Ends up, it's 1942.
It's a 3 over here. Look at that. Oh, it's just going to a different one. That's it.
Okay, just rechecked the hole after talking to Dad. And there's another one down there. Hopefully this one's a silver dime. Let's find out. Oh. Boy, this camera really messes with my detector. Let's see. Get it out. Nope. Oh, look at there. There's a bottle cap underneath the underneath the penny. That's why I was giving such a crappy signal. Yeah, oh well. Better than nothing. Well, just went about another 5 feet, and I got a 19, looks like a 1920 wheat penny. Cool. It's coming up as a 36, which it shouldn't have. That'd be a zinc penny, but wasn't down very far, about 5 inches. Cool. See you at the next hole. Well, I just got a strange signal. Way down here in the hole, I get it out. I have no idea what that is. It's too small to be a dime. Let me clean it up. Be right back to you. Well, it turns out it's a token. It says Retail Credit Company Reports Service. Huh. No clue. The other side's the same. A little more crusty, but interesting. Another token I never found. Well, on to the next hole. Just got me another nickel. That's oh, you can see it, 1949. One on each side. Get one in the middle and we got silver. Next hole, bye. Just got me another wheat penny. 1930S. Huh. It's down. It's down about 6 inches. Cool. Next hole. Well, just got me another wheat penny. It's 1945. I don't know if you can see it or not. Cool. Dad's way over there. Got some friends too. Chasing him. Where is he? There he is. Taking some. Well, get back to you on the next hole. Just got another nickel. This time it's a 1948. Oh, you can see it. Getting closer to a silver nickel. Next hole. Back again. Thought I just had a weedy down here, but if you could see down in here. I see silver. Oh, I could even see a date. Oh my God. I believe that's a barber. Hang on a second, let me clean it up. Well, I've got it cleaned up. I think it's a 1905 barber. She's pretty worn, but hey, I'll take it. I didn't expect to find that down here. It's got a S mint mark on it.
Laying under leaves for
cool.
70 years.
Got another wheat penny. Looks like 1939. Cool. I think that's 9 now. Next hole. Bye. All right. Switched gears here. Put on the little tiny coil. I'm digging through all the trash around the bathhouse here. And I just got, this is my 9th wheat. Not like the last one. This one's a 1955D. Cool. Get back to you on the next hole. Well, just got weedy number 10 of the day. That's 1944D. Made a lot of them. That's why you always find a lot of them. Next hole. Look what I found laying in the middle of the tennis court, or basketball court. No, it's not marked.
Look on the top.
Gotta be silver.
see anything on it. Thumbs up is silver on the locator. Oh well. Free for me. Well, it's got wheat penny number 11 for the day. 1951. Oh. Okay, next one.
Okay, time for the paper plate roundup. Got that one from JD's Coins. Here in the grow room, because it's the only place I got decent light, I had some pink mushrooms that finally came out. They've been in the dark for a while. They ain't got much color on them, but I'll start with Thursday stuff I found. I had a 52 wheat, 45 something crusty, 44D, 39P, 48S, 45P, 46D, 45P, 47D, 54D Silver Rosie, 56D Silver Rosie, 37D Mercury. It's got some nice toning on it. It's a nice looking coin. It's pretty worn out, but looks nice. 42D and 44P. That's what I got on Thursday. That was pretty good. I figured I'd go back to the same spot with that many wheats and that many silvers, there'd be more there. Well, apparently not. There was plenty of wheats though. I got 11 wheats today. 48D, 49P, 41P, 52D, 20S. 20S seems like a key date to me. I gotta look it up. 42P, 45P, 30S, that seems like a key date too, but 44D, they made millions of those. That's why I got so many of them. 39P, 58D, 55D, 44P, 51D, and of course we all saw the 1905S Barber. And it's that park was built in the late 20s. It's finished in the early 30s. So what? It was probably still in circulation in the 30s. I found a lot of old coins down there in the fill that came in with it, just like this 1897. Oh, that's in one of my other videos. That's about a $60 coin. That 1905, that's another key date. This one's only worth about $5 or $6 because it's in such bad shape. I think the other, let's see what the other side looks like. Well, it's not in very good shape, it's pretty wore out. But some of them on there are going for thousands of dollars for nice ones. But, yeah, oh well, it's silver, works for me. Of course, we all saw that token. I have no clue what that is. Some kind of credit company. When was the last time you seen one of those? That's an old pull tab. Well, I'll get back there again. I'll pick through it. All these silvers and wheats pretty much came out of one little spot. I don't know why they're there. I don't know why nobody's found it. But, hey, that's the way it is. Keep looking, keep finding. Find some mushrooms. And I'll get back next time. Thanks for watching. Bye. Wait, we're not done yet. Forgot to thank Dad for getting me hooked on this damn hobby so I could find stupid things in the ground. And hopefully they're worth money. Well, if you have any idea what that is a $2.50 gold coin. I actually
took all the gold that I found the first year and traded it for this $2.50 gold coin. Show you the other side. 1925. It's about 300, well, gold's crap now, so probably about $300. But for first year gold digging, it worked. These are some of the other rings I got. Lots of silver. There's a few golds over there. I'll give you a preview at the end of the year. Maybe I'll do a roundup. See what happens. Talk to you later. Bye. Thanks, Dad.